gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen,
mic check.
Mic check.
Mic check.
Mic check.
We're here today. Our police brutality. Police terror. This is what we call it. Let's first of all deal with the people who we're here to speak about today. Let's first of all deal with the people who we're here to talk about today.
Right, so they're cops.
ID,
they were here long before anyone got here waiting. So
We don't give them no information at all.
Just I'm down with that.
You get this guy behind you. Chief Brown! Chief Brown! Chief of Dallas Police Department is pretty much trying to maintain quote unquote book by lying and paying certain spending certain stories in the media. Y'all know this is some bullshit. That's why y'all here. That's why y'all here, because y'all know this is some bullshit. What we have to do, ladies and gentlemen, we have to put solution-based plans into action. We have to produce solution-based plans into action. What this means is we have to be willing, number one, namely, to go into the community and educate them that, hey, number one, we can't expect the Dallas Police Department to accurately protect and serve us, because they're the one that's killing us at the same time. Right?
Right.
We have to get people to realize it. We have to get them to shake out. Stop calling the goddamn police every time you got a motherfucking problem. Stop calling. Hey, if you got a problem with this man, talk to this man and figure out exactly what your issues is and try to work it out that way. Can everybody agree to that?
Yeah.
Stop calling the damn police every time. But number two, after we figure out we stop calling the police, what the guerrilla mainframe has done, we out there on, what is that? We at the bridge coffee shop watching they motherfucking ass. And you ought to see the police running. They running from us. But normally, the rabbit, this time the rabbit has a gun. You understand what I'm saying? That's a whole different feel when the rabbit got the gun. And so we're doing police cop watch, watching them, and making sure that they ain't fucking up, because they fucked up, we gonna fuck their ass up right there. On the spot. That's how you deal with it. You put that camera on their ass, and they all of a sudden they get scared. We got so many pictures yesterday from what happened last night. So many pictures. So many officers shaking and laughing and doing all this and that. They was having a good time out there. We got so many pictures of that. But what I challenge us here and for the community down there, because if you ride down Dixon Circle right now, what you'll see is a lot of people down there already. They ready. That's an organized community, ladies and gentlemen. That's organized. Those people down there are very much so organized. And so we want to build solutions. And I'm going to let you take it.
I'll say a couple of things about the cop watch. Whenever we first came out there, I started this with my comrade Oscar. And my little sister Savannah. They were out there. They were out at the bridge homeless shelter, walking by, had nothing to do with it, and they happened to notice two cops standing above a homeless man who was sleeping on the ground, writing him a ticket for sleeping on the ground while he's crying his eyes out. You know, and them seeing this, you know, it broke both of their hearts. They came back to us, to Guerrilla Mainframe, and said we have to start doing something about this. So pretty much every night for 3 or 4 weeks, we were out there every single night. The cops came up and they harassed us hard. They came up on the little segways, like 8 of them at a time. They circled me and Oscar in the street and tried to threaten us, tried to intimidate us. We stood our ground. We told them we weren't going to back down, that we weren't going to stop fighting. And after the first 2 or 3 run-ins like that, where we threw the law in their face, whenever they realized they couldn't touch us, they started to back down. They started to get intimidated. What we started doing is training the homeless people, educating the homeless people about their rights as citizens, about their start getting scared. You know, some of us,
weapons against anybody. I don't care what uniform you're wearing. If you kick my door down, you're going to run into something that you're not going to want to see on the other side of it. I don't care who you are. And we need to get the communities in a situation to where they can do the same, where they can defend themselves, and to where they have the law on their side. And I don't know, that's all I have to say. You need to start talking to your neighbors and your friends and the less fortunate and get them educated on what they can do to defend themselves. And you know, we do public education, we take some time on it. So our public education is on Saturdays at 2:30 p.m. until 4:30 p.m. at the MLK Center on Boulevard in Southern Dallas. Anyone's welcome to come out. We'll educate you on your rights, we'll educate you on the laws, we'll educate you on your rights to defend yourself, and we'll also educate you on how to defend yourself.